Rupert Murdoch.
Rupert Murdoch.
Rupert Murdoch and his wife
number four, supermodel Jeri Hall,
are set to get divorced.
Divorce.
Divorce.
It's not just the wives of billionaire media tycoons who are busy filing for
D-I-V-O-R-S-E.
Turns out loads of Aussies are.
Definitely since the pandemic, I've had an increase in inquiries with new clients.
It's over. Finished. Burrito.
Yep, COVID has not only ruined free food samples, birthday candles and the high five, it's taken a toll on our relationships too.
Are you a victim of the COVID breakup?
Having to stop work, stop social distractions and sports and hobbies that they were perhaps filling their time with. All of a sudden, spending large amounts of time with their partner, it highlighted how much they had grown apart.
Nearly 200,000 Aussies have filed for divorce in the past 2 years, the highest number in more than a decade. Those in the business of helping people consciously uncouple say it's just the tip of the iceberg.
From the data we're seeing, we are predicting a higher rate of separation and divorce. We've been through floods, a pandemic. There's now quite a lot of financial distress with what's coming up with inflation. These are all things that will impact separation and divorce rates.
If divorcees can't agree on terms and have to go through the courts, it can cost between $50,000 and $100,000.
Divorce, babe, divorce.
And of course, there's the emotional cost.
My emotions! My emotions!
Divorce and separation is considered the second most stressful thing that someone might experience in their lifetimes. Everything is turned upside down, so it is a very vulnerable time for a lot of people, and it's quite challenging trying to navigate the system itself.
I mean, I feel fine. I just cry myself to sleep every night.
Yeah, that's totally normal.
But for those who are heading for Splitsville, the divorce doctors say there is light at the end of the tunnel.
When you are in your 40s and in your 50s, even in your late 30s, you are a better judge of who you are as a person. Everything is not lost. There is so much from actually taking a second chance at love later on in life.
Well, I've got quite a few friends going through COVID divorces. Do you guys have people in your lives? How many? I don't know. Maybe three in my reasonably close friend circle.
Yeah, I've had a couple.
Specifically because of the impact of COVID.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I guess that's the idea we're tabling, isn't it? That the lockdown, especially. I live in Melbourne, so I mean, we've had a lot of time to really look that person in the eye and go. No! And I support it. I think it's a really romantic idea. I like the fact that COVID has fast-tracked what we used to need to have a home renovation to fast-track. Do you know what I mean? Like, so in some ways, we're saving the money that we would normally spend. You know, like
it
testing
kind of
our
feels
compatibility.
Slightly like you've been coaching these friends.
Yeah.
Well, do you know what? In all cases, they're better off apart.
Yeah.
So, no, I mean, it's great that they discovered it.
Yeah. I feel like the COVID lockdowns and the isolation, having to spend time together, has actually improved my relationship because, like, we actually have to spend time together now and, like, talk. You know, because you can't escape and whatever. I mean, that's certainly my opinion. My girlfriend may disagree entirely.
And we have Michael Hing's girlfriend.